Hey, it's Derek here from the Sideshow Guys. We're back with another Amazon delivery here. This is from A&UTV PRO. We are looking for a tablet mount for the Honda Talon here, so I can see where we're going and where we've been and so forth. The Talon doesn't have a tablet mount or anything, so we reached out to this company here and they hooked us up with this product for a tablet mount for the Honda Talon. We're putting it in the Honda Talon 1000R. I believe it fits anywhere from a 2019 to present Honda Talon. We'll find that out here in a few moments. So let's dig into the box here and see what they sent us. Looks like it's been double boxed up. That's pretty good of them. Throw that aside. Got some double-sided tape here and a couple screws. This is the what we're really looking for here though. Looks like it does come with some instructions here. Double-sided. Says there should be six screws, strip of double-sided tape, as well as the one device holder. We'll set that aside. Get the box out of the way. Get this box out of the way. So this is what we're looking at here. Should slide open like this. Put your device in there, lock it down. Does have a push button here to open up. It's got a storage compartment inside for a little extra storage. There's where we adjust for our tablet. You tighten it up, loosen it off to slide this piece up and down. So because it slides up and down, it does fit a few different tablets, iPads, Samsung tablets. I believe mine's a Samsung A4 or A8 we'll be using. The Honda does have a switch panel, so it does have the knockouts for the switches to move them to this piece. So we'll get around to installing this, see how it goes in there. We'll read over the instructions and see if we can get this installed today. Okay, we got everything all unpacked here. We need a 5mm Allen socket here. We need a 5mm Allen socket here to take the two bolts. As per the instructions here, there's two bolts right here on your Honda Talon. You got to take one on each side out. Then we'll put the mount in, and I'll show you here. These two bolts go through here, the stock bolts go back in. There are two holes here as well for screws. That's what these screws are for, and two go along the top here as well, and they'll screw into the Honda plastics. This is the tablet I'm running, which is a Samsung, I think, A8 tablet. So it'll go in like so. Be able to use our Polaris Ride Command app there. We also use the Quad On app as well for all our local trails here in Ontario. They do have the foam will sit below the tablet here to hold it tight. You put a piece at the top, the bottom, you can put a piece behind it too, because there is a little bit of play here that can be tightened up, but that's what this foam stripping's for. They give you a thick one here as well as a thin one. Depends on like if you have a case on your tablet. I got a case with a screen protector. So it's very flexible for what you need to do depending on what tablet setup you're running. Of course, got a screwdriver here to do our screws. So we'll get around to installing this. Like I said, the screw here is gonna come out. 5mm Allen for it. This compartment here, it does cover a little bit of it. You still have this compartment underneath though. You still have use of it. And that'll go on there. Like I said, you still have this compartment. It's cut off a little bit, but it's still there. I might have misspoke the 19, I think it's the 2022 that had the gauges here. You'd have to get a gauge relocate to this position in order to run this one. It still would fit the same in the older machines because they haven't changed the layout of the dash. It's just to move the gauges. So the other modification I made to mine is this did have this here, and it had this breakouts for the switch. This here, I cut it out because I'm going to use the factory one there, and it gives full access to all my switches without remounting them. They're all in there ready to go if I want to add more. They are in behind this, but one's a USB port, the other one's for a winch. My winch, I do have a wireless remote for it, for my Super ATV winch, so I don't really need to get in at that switch. And if my passenger needs to, They just open it up and the switch is there. So it's not a big deal to me. So we'll get this mounted up. Like I said, we start with the two stock bolts that go back in here. We'll get them started in there. 5 millimeter Allen to get these threaded in there. So it uses the stock hardware, which is nice. You know it's gonna fit. It's Honda hardware. Snug them up here. Get it hand tight in, then we'll tighten it up. Again, these don't have to be crazy tight. You're just tighten them into a metal clip, so they don't have to be crazy tight. Make sure we're sitting down where we want here. Get our screws. These are self-tapping screws. So like I said, there's two at the top here and two at this side, same as this side. Hopefully you can see that. Just remember, you're just screwing into a bit of plastic. So again, you don't have to go too crazy tight with them. I guess if you ever did want to remove this, if you sold the machine, you wanted to put it into a new machine, you'll have 6 little screw holes, two at the top there. Shouldn't look bad, but for the price of these, I think this is about just shy of $150 Canadian for us. A little cheaper for you Americans. You got a little better value on the dollar. So we'll get putting our tablet in here, put our foam on to get it sitting right. Like I said, again, I cut this all out so I can get all my switches. This is my USB that I'll plug the tablet into to charge it. I'm thinking I can bring the cord out into the side of the tablet. We get this adjusted up here. Like I said, this is what adjusts for the different size tablets. It slides up and down for the different size tablets, depending on what tablet you're going with. I do still have my phone mount over here for my phone or for the wife's phone so she can have her music going. Because I do have sound bars, so she likes her music at her fingertips. Got the remote here for it. We'll get the tablet in here, see if we can get her set up. Like I said, we got our little cord. I got a fairly short little cord for my tablet. So we'll have constant power. I'll wind that up inside for now. We'll have to get this set for the height of the tablet. So we get that locked down. It's a nice tablet, right in the center of the machine. Easy to see, easy to read. Like I said, it's a Samsung tablet, Galaxy tablet, powered by Android. It'll, this here, I think for us, is just like under $200 for the tablet Canadian. Again, the stuff in the States is cheaper. I know my buddy Eric's got the same tablet, as well as he's got an iPad mini, I think, in his Polaris. Plus he's got the stock factory screen. So he swaps out the iPad with the Samsung tablet, depending on where we're going and which maps. He's got a lot of maps all tracked, or a lot of trails all tracked here in Ontario. So this is just so I can pay attention a bit better and see where all we're going, where we've been. We get the ride command set up on this and teaming up with Eric so we can see where each other's at, which will be nice. We'll let that power up while we get some foam here set up. I'm going with the thinner foam here. Hopefully I could just need something to sit on. My tablet's in a case, so it's pretty well protected, so I don't need much for in the way of protection on the bottom here. We'll test fit it again here. Gives a little cushion there to squeeze it down in. That'll tighten up once we tighten that piece at the back up. I'm gonna put a little piece along the front edge there. Again, you gotta play around with the foam, the different thicknesses there to get it the way you want. I'm pretty happy with that. Like I said, you squeeze that down in there. We'll tighten up our knob on the back here. It's just a little hand knob. And there we go. We got our tablet set up. It's still about to move it slightly in here. I'm gonna go to our main screen here, I think. Right here, player's ride command. This is one of the last places we ride in the Minden area there. So I haven't got this, as it has been hooked up to the internet in a while. I'll have to get it synced with the internet, and then I'll get it with Eric. As you know, Eric's got a Polaris, so he has the built-in screen with ride command. I'll get it paired with him. We can keep track of where we are, where we're going. So yeah, I'm very happy with this product here from you and A&UTV Pro. Like I said, you can find this online, look them up, check out whatever else they have for the different machines. This is what they had for the Talon. They have other stuff as well, so check them out. If you do want to take the tablet out, you drop it down, undo your screw here, pull your tablet out, take it in the house or take it into the hotel you're staying at, so nobody can steal your tablet. Should be a good addition to the machine and help us on our rides. I'm hoping I can pull this cord out through here at the side, I'm hoping, which yes, that'll work. Fairly clean looking install, so thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. We'll have some more install videos coming up here, so stay tuned to the channel and we'll catch you on the next one.